Like, I'm not selling my house. I'm like, good, you know, great. I'm not calling you to try to get you to sell your house.
Like, what has been the routines that you've implemented to drive success, both personally and professionally?
I think there is some magic secrets out there. I think keeping things really extremely simple. I think we tend to overcomplicate and overthink everything. Keep it really simple. It's all about just talking to people, making them feel comfortable, right? And I think the biggest thing with people fearing the phone and not wanting to, you know, and they're scared of this or that, you should be super confident in who you are and what you're there for. You know, like if you're a brand new agent, you don't have a lot of experience. You actually have a leg up on a lot of experienced agents because you have time, right? Like when I'm talking to somebody and I'm a new agent, I'm saying, look, Mr. Seller, you want me because I'm new, because I'm going to work on your deal for 8 hours a day. And the agent that's doing a hunt, you know, I want you to call right now while I'm in front of you. I want you to call Ricky and ask him where your deal is going to be on his priority list, Mr. 100 deals a year. Right? He could probably say yours is a priority, but he can't say it's going to be the number one priority, right? But having confidence in who you are, that you're there to help people, whereas if someone gets mad or hangs up on you or rejects you or doesn't like you or whatever, it's like that's their loss, because look, I'm here to help you. If you don't realize it, if you don't believe me, then good luck to you. I'm sorry it didn't work out, but there's going to be people that do love me because I love people, and you're going to attract who you are, right? So having, like, who you are, if you really care, should give you the confidence to overcome any kind of rejection, any kind of, you know, negativity, because you're there to help. You know, when somebody answers the phone and I'm like, hey, this is Ricky Carruth, Remix of Orange Beach. They're like, I'm not selling my house. I'm like, good, you know, great. I'm not calling you to try to get you to sell your house.
I didn't expect you to.
Yeah, like, I'm not calling you for that, by the way. I'm calling you, I don't want to know what I can't do for you. I want to know what I can do to help you. And so when they come at me, I'm going to give it right back at them. And you'll even see on some of my live calls, I hang up on people before they hang up on me. It's like, I can see where this is going and I don't have time for this. You know what I'm saying?
I love that.
Yeah, because at the end of the day, it's unlimited. I mean, you can't call them all. You can't help everybody. There's more than you can ever handle forever. So what was the question, bro?
Nah, man. I mean, I think you hit some nails right there when you were talking about just your mindset of being and helping people. But ultimately, yeah, it's what other routines? Is there anything?
Well, the routines, like at the end of the day, that's all fine and dandy if you love people and you help, you care about people, but that doesn't matter if you're not talking to enough people, right?
Yes.
This is where people really get sideways. They get a couple of clients who like them and they just start focusing and trying to convert those few clients, right? When that should probably take up, you know, 0.001% of your time. Meanwhile, you're trying to find more people to help. See, when you slow down the growth of your prospecting or your lead generation or whatever you're doing to attract business, to try to convert people that may or may not convert, you're putting yourself in a super dangerous position because they may or may not convert, A, and B, you're taking that time away from helping more people that may convert. You know, whenever you say yes to something, you're saying no to several other things, and you really gotta understand this whole time situation, because time, we all have the same amount of hours in a day. And if you're not utilizing the time the way it needs to be, people are doing things that don't matter, like fixing their websites, working on business cards, doing a social media ad, like all these things don't matter. Like they matter, but they matter after You do, you they matter after you've done your 3 hours of follow-up or cold calling or you know, like that stuff matters after. People are putting that ahead of the calls, and then they end up doing that all day and never get to the calls, or maybe they never even have the call scheduled because they're just not going to make calls. You know, and those are the people that end up having to get out of the business. But if I can get inside their head and I can say, listen, it's not what you think. We're not trying to put people in awkward situations. We're calling to see if there's anything in the world we can do to help them. That's it. And like, we focused on that answer to that question. And you know, it's like a yay or a nay thing. You know, like, you do have an agent you would work with if you were to do something cool. Let's stay in touch. Like, how hard is that, man? Pretend like this is your mom, dad, brother, cousin. But the problem, like I say, we're not doing it enough. Like, if we're a good person, here's the thing. There's an unlimited amount of loyal clients for every single agent. Listen to that again. Unlimited amount of loyal clients that'll never use another agent ever in their life out there for every single agent, unlimited. The problem is that the agent hasn't got out there and found those people.
Yep.
Right? It's like a needle in a haystack. There's, you know, one in 50 people, you know, or 1 in 30 or 1 in 50 or 1 in 100, depending on you and how well you communicate, is going to be that loyal client forever. And you want to stop when you get to 200 people when you have four loyal clients. When if you'd have just kept going, you could get that up to 100 loyal clients, 200 loyal clients, 300 loyal clients, 500 loyal clients. And then you got a business. Now we can be number one. You know, now we can sell 100 properties a year. But, you know, we quit trying to get our message out there.
Dude, I love it, man. I just want you to keep going. I mean, there's so much in there to unpack, but I really think you are hitting a real core differentiator for people to understand. You see two types of people, or at least this is what I see. In sales, you see the aggressive, you know, they call, they're pushing, they're setting appointments, they're all about the appointment, they're all about the close. And then you see the people who are all about the value. It's like, I don't want to set any appointments, I just want to get value out there, and it's all just about the fluffy value. The people who can get both together, where I'm hustling, I'm calling to get value, are the winner. They're the winner in every business, and that's what you are bringing together. I mean, that right there is amazing.
You know,
I love how you said it, and I'm gonna butcher it, but you said it. It's like, you can be the one who wants to get value, but if you're not talking to anybody, you can get value. It doesn't matter.
Right, right.